We're standing in the very quiet church of Santa Sabina on the Aventine Hill in Rome, late in the day, so it's a little bit dark and very empty. And I think we're as close to what an early Christian church looked like as we can get.
This is a church that was borrowing directly from the classical, the ancient Roman tradition of the basilica. But instead of using the basilica as a gathering place for political events, for the courts, here it's been turned into a sacred space.
The early Christians who needed a type of building that would hold large numbers of people with a focus for the altar adapted this form from the ancient Romans, because at one end is the entrance and on the other end is a semicircular area called the apse, which would be where the judge or the magistrate or the emperor would sit, and that becomes the place of the altar.
On either side of the main nave, the main hallway, sort of this great space, are these side aisles divided by this gorgeous row of Corinthian columns.
They're beautiful. They're a little bit tapered. They're very graceful in their proportions. So we have this colonnade on either side down the nave, supporting round arches for a nave arcade. And we have a flat roof.
Right, flat ceiling.
Over the nave, so we don't have a vaulted ceiling. So that also, I think, would be how a Roman basilica would look.
I think very often that's right. There's a spareness here, and a lack of a kind of decorative program that you see in so many later churches, so that really the basic forms of the church are pure and here and just gorgeous.
So you get the nave arcade and then this spare space above it that I guess in some Byzantine churches, for example, in Ravenna would have contained mosaics, a flat expansive wall, and then above that a clear story to let in light.
Yeah, although here, interestingly, there's translucent material, not glass. So I think even on a relatively sunny day, I'm not sure how bright it gets here.
But, you know, this is such a difference from so many of the other churches that we've seen in Rome with their Baroque grandeur. And there are, of course, some Baroque aspects here that were added obviously much later
in some of the tombs
and the chapels. And like so many of the churches we've seen in Rome, there's a kind of accrual, you know, an accretion of history and different styles. But here we have this very pure early Christian basilican form.
It's really the early Christians adopting those earlier Roman traditions, really finding their own vocabulary, their own uses for this space,
right,
and really making it their own.
And this is, we're talking only, you know, a little bit more than 100 years after Constantine makes Christianity legal within the empire. So we're very close to the beginnings of the official legal church. And the apse once had a mosaic at the top, but now it has a fresco.
And the fresco apparently follows the original cartoon or the original forms of the mosaic quite closely.
And there's supposedly some really great wooden doors. Should we go look at those?
I think original wooden doors. Let's go find them.
From the 5th century.
Let's find them.